Hi there, Sophie Walker here and welcome to our Golfalot channel. Today I'll be talking you through the new offerings from Cobra, the Aerojet drivers. As always, there's three to choose from, the low spin, the standard, and the max. I'm going to compare the three, see who I think they're suited to, talk you through the technology, and give you my opinion on all three of these drivers. But before we start the video, please make sure you like this video, comment below if you are a low spin, a standard, or a max player when it comes to drivers, and ring that bell. Subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our content. The story behind this year's models, it's all in the name, Aerojet. So there's aerodynamics, we've got a power bridge in there and a new face to these drivers. I'll talk you through that in more detail later on. Testing will include all three of the drivers. I'll hit 10 with each to compare them and talk you through the looks, the sound and the feel also. Beginning with the standard Aerojet, I can see that the matte finish is gone. We've now got the black shine. Accent colours this year are white and blue. The orange and the white has gone. But in terms of head shape, still looks big. The Cobra heads do look very big. Couple of toe strikes to start, hence the shape. Ball speed, not quite getting to that 130 miles per hour because of that strike. However, carry is decent. It's easily over 200. There we go, it's getting closer to the middle, that 212 carry. Ball speed's still not getting over that 130 yet. So I'm gonna just keep testing, get into this testing, and hopefully I'll see that move. However, 212 yards carry for ball speed under 130 miles an hour. I'm happy with that. That sounded hit. That sounded like more of a crack. So I'm now getting up to that 132 ball speed, 220 yard carry. That's good. That's good numbers. Still feel like there could be something more in that. I don't know if it's the feedback I'm getting from the face. It's not as thick and as solid as I want off the face just yet. Yeah, those toe strikes, that's me. That's dropping the spin rate down and turning it over. Certainly some left bias to these strikes with me and the head in general, which is not a bad thing, is it? Because most people that are going to play this head want to see a little bit of falling to the left. Good numbers though, like 220 yard carries, good numbers. The main story behind Aerojet across the board with these Cobra clubs is the power bridge. It was inspired by Da Vinci's bridge in the fact that it is the same shape. It sits at the bottom of the club behind the face, providing stability, higher launch, and quicker ball speeds. With the PowerShell hot face, they're suggesting you could get anything up to 1.5 miles per hour more ball speed than the LTDx. They're also saving weight with a carbon crown. So the crown and the sole, that's not where the weight needs to be. That structure needs to be as light as possible, so they're saving weight there so they can move it to where they need it most to lower that CG, put some weight behind the golf ball to increase the power. So there's more flexion in the face. The weight is in the right part of the club, depending on which one you have, obviously. If you're using the max, it's going to be more weight towards the back of the club. But the power bridge is something that they're very proud of. They're keen on. It's in all of the clubs from irons through to drivers, and it's inspired by Da Vinci. In terms of custom fit, they have the MyFly loft setting, so you can make the driver flatter or increase and decrease loft. You can also change the weights in these heads. So that's a real great way to move that weight around to lower ball flight or make the flight more left or right biased. Shaft-wise, there's a range of premium shafts. Today I'm testing with the 65 gram stiff. And in terms of loft offerings, if you want the LS, it's 9 degree and 10.5. And then in the other two models, you've got 9 degree, 10.5 and 12 degree. I've just grabbed the LS head, looking down, noticeably different in shape. it looks smaller, the face looks deeper, whereas the standard, it looks wider across heel to toe and shallower from top to bottom. I actually really like the LS head. It's just not as elongated. And when we're talking about aerodynamics, which is these aerojets, it's a big thing. Almost the tail of this LS, it's higher. It's a lot higher, okay? So this is designed for people that swing it fast, really quick. It might make it slightly less forgiving. So they're saying that people are using this, maybe are the better player that will find the middle of the face more, be more stable at impact anyway. So because of this steepness at the back, it's going to get the ball, the club head moving quicker, sorry, through the air. But we might give up a little bit of forgiveness because of that. So the head shape totally changed in the LS for this year. In terms of the standard, this is the same head as last year's LS. So the same shape, sorry, head. And then the draw, which is the max, that is the same shape as last year's LTDx standard. So the promoted better aerodynamics in all of the heads, but especially this LS one, we're really seeing a noticeable change. It's a really, really good looking head, this. For me, as I say, a lot more inviting head shape, still the shine of the crown rather than the matte of last year. Oh, that was quite a good example there. So ball speed, 133 miles per hour. Best I've seen in this testing so far. Spin dropped below 2000. So I'm thinking, yeah, that's gonna go a long way. And actually it didn't carry over that 220 yard mark because of the low spin. So it's doing exactly what it should do. Now these clubs are aimed at somebody that swings it faster than me. That one there, just short of 19 mile per hour club speed. I don't swing it fast enough to get the optimum out of this driver, but it is doing what it says. It is low spinning. And if you swing it at least at that 100 yard mark, I think this could be really good for you if you want to just take down that spin. Then spin jumps. So when you don't quite strike it, that was slightly low off the face. I'm now pushing 3000 RPM. So spin variation on those two shots there was over, well, about 1000, wasn't it, RPM? So that's just showing the versatility in the head, but also the forgiveness isn't quite there as what it would be on a standard or a max. Over 1000 in spin is a lot, okay? I didn't feel like I did a whole lot different other than strike it slightly lower off the face. Moving into the max head, it's maximum in size, it looks like. I know it's 460cc, but it looks bigger. Remember, the bigger the head, the more stable it'll be. You might take off a little bit of speed, but you'll get the stability there because of it. Deep face, long face, plenty of hitting area. The most forgiving looking of the drivers, and it's aimed at players wanting the most forgiveness. Maybe to sacrifice a little bit of length, but it's more to try and keep it on the fairway, which in turn will make it go further. It should be less left biased also. Well, yeah, about a foot left biased. Yeah, this feels incredibly just sturdy and just nice and straight. Worth noting with this head that we have the weights in the heel and at the back, 12 at the back. If you wanted to move the 12 gram to the heel, you should get some more left bias there. Now I felt that was gonna go right. Yep, it did. Still gonna hit the fairway though, isn't it? And still had a good flight. This is going to look after you. It's going to get the ball in the air. If you do catch it low off the face, it's not going to drop out the air. It's still going to look after you in launch. Looking through the data, the low spin for me went the furthest just in carry at 210. Next up was the Aerojet, which was literally just below that. And then 206 carry for the Max. Kind of expected that ball speed was slightly down with the Max. It was more like it looked after me through the strike. Maybe lost a bit of pace in order to make sure the launch stayed consistent, and so did the shot shape. Looking at the spin, in my testing, low spin spun more on average, and you're like, oh, what? That doesn't make sense. It does, because if I've caught it low off the face or towards the toe, so towards the toe, the spin will drop off. Low off the face, the spin will pick up. I'll tell you about that big variation that I had. That's why my average sits higher. If you are fitted for LS and you suit LS, which is a faster swing speed than mine, and maybe a little bit more at the center, so if I do hit mine slightly toey in general, if I miss anything, it is towards the toe, then the low spin really does drop out the air, and vice versa with low off the face. In terms of the Aerojet, that did spin a little bit less than the Aerojet Max, which is exactly what you would look to do. I think this is pretty clear in the test, and you can see by dispersion as well, with the LS having the furthest left one, and then add a few to the right, that is this adjustable head that's got some flight variation. It's maybe not quite as forgiving, but it's quicker. So if you've got more control in that area and you're all about speed, the LS is for you, aimed at the better golfer. The Max is somebody that is wanting a big head that, when you look down on it, it gives you confidence. It might not all be about hitting it a million miles. It's about keeping it on the planet. If you lose a couple of yards in distance in order to make sure you hit the fairway, then you're winning. Because if you're landing on the short stuff, it's going to roll further, isn't it? Bearing in mind, I only gave up a handful of yards between that driver and the low spin. I think for me, I sit somewhere between the low spin and the Max. I quite liked the precision of the Max. It just felt that little bit easier to hit. However, the head shape on the LS was great. So I think I would work my way into the LS head shape, because it looks so good at address. It's kind of Titleist-esque at address, which is something that I play right now. But overall, these heads are doing what they say they do. And in terms of the size, I think that is a really nice indication of the type of player that is going to use them. So there we have it, three models from Cobra as part of the Aerojet range. Now, last year I voted the Cobra LTDx as my favorite driver of the year in our comparisons, and I'm thinking that the Aerojet will be right up there. It has a lot to compete against, but that LS in looks, it's really nice. Head along to golfalot.com to read the written review on all three of these drivers. In the meantime, make sure you like this video. Comment below, what head do you like using? Is it low spin? Is it standard? Or is it a Max version? And make sure you ring the bell on this video. Do not miss out on any of our content. Thank you all for watching once again, and I'll see you again soon.